Welcome to Hope of Glory, a teaching ministry of Pastor Esau Banda, the Senior Pastor of Pentecost International Christian Center, PICC, the ministry chosen, ordained, and anointed by God to bring hope to the hopeless and life to the dying and help them become true disciples of Jesus Christ. Here is Pastor Esau Banda. God bless you as you listen.
Father, we bless and honor your holy name. You are such an awesome God. We thank you for testimonies of change that are pouring in from all over the country. Testimonies of healing and deliverance. Testimonies of your power. The glory manifesting in the lives and situations of your people. In the mighty name of Jesus, you are enlarging us on every side. And for this, we shall be forever grateful. In Jesus' mighty name. We thank you for this opportunity, O God, to share your word with your people. Anoint these lips of clay, O God, so that the preaching of your word be with the demonstration of the Spirit and power. For the deliverance and restoration of your people. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Well, we greet you in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank God for what He's doing. I will be sharing with you today. And I believe next week also. On a message entitled Divine Visitation. Divine Visitation. Because God has purposed to visit somebody's life. That long standing situation in your life is about to experience divine visitation. In the mighty name of Jesus. That is how I know your season of weeping is over. Your season of groaning is over. Because the Lord is coming to you with a visitation. He has purposed to visit you this time. I know you have waited long enough. But you know that God is never too late. That is why He is arriving this time around. If you are ready for it, shout hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Now use for a text Genesis chapter 50.
Genesis chapter 50.
Verses 22 to 26. Genesis chapter number 50.
Genesis 50.
Verses 22 to 26.
The
Bible says,
Bible ikuti,
and Joseph dwelt in Egypt, he and his father's house, and Joseph lived 110 years.
Ndipo Yosefu anakhala mwa Igupto, iye ndi mbumba ya atate wake. Ndipo Yosefu anakhala ndi moyo zaka zana limodzi ndi khumi.
Joseph saw Ephraim's children of the third generation, the generation of Machir, the son of Manasseh, were brought up upon Joseph's knees.
Ndipo Yosefu anaona ana Ephraim ambado wachitatu, anaso amaliki mwana wa mamuna wa Manasseh, anabadwa pa mabondo a Yosefu.
And Joseph said unto his brethren, I die, and God will surely visit you and bring you out of this land and to the land which I swear to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob.
Ndipo Yosefe ndipo anati kwa abale ache, nilinkufa ine, koma Mulungu adzaonekera kwa inu, adzakuchotsani inu dziko muno, kubwera kunka ku dziko limene analumbirira kwa Abraham ndi kwa Isaki ndi kwa Yakobo.
And Joseph took an oath of the children of Israel, saying, God will surely visit you, and you shall carry up my bones from hence. So Joseph died, being 110 years old, and they embalmed him, and he was put in a coffin in Egypt. Divine visitation. What is a divine visitation? When we talk of a divine visitation, we are talking about the release of God's power that destroys the opposition and sets his people free. The release of God's power that destroys the opposition and sets his people free. And I want us to know, friends, that God is about to release a special power upon your lives and situations, and every opposition is going to be destroyed. Every destroyer is going to be destroyed. And this very same power, this very same power, is going to set you free from every form of darkness in the mighty name of Jesus. Listen to me.
Veteran,
talking about God's visitation. God can visit a group of people or an individual. We read in this passage of scripture, in this Genesis chapter 50, verses 22 to 26, that Joseph prophesied. He declared unto his brothers that God was going to visit them as a group, as a nation of people. And this idea of God's visitation upon his people was declared by God himself in Genesis chapter 15, when God made a covenant with Abraham. He spoke to him in verses 13 to 16. God said to him, he said, "Know for certain that your descendants will be strangers in a country not of their own." And he told him, he said, "Your descendants are going to be enslaved in that country. And they are going to be mistreated for 400 years. And then God gave Abraham a promise. He said, "But I will punish the nation they serve as slaves. And afterward they will come out with great possessions." And that was God's promise unto his people. It was a promise of his visitation. And the same God who promised a visitation for his people has commissioned me today to announce to you that he is about to visit you. He is arranging a special visitation unto you in the mighty name of Jesus. And so it happened in Exodus chapter 3. Many years after Joseph was long gone, God appeared unto Moses, who was in a mountain of Horeb, which is also called the mountain of God. And God spoke to him in Exodus chapter 3, verses 7 to 8. God speaking to Moses, he said, "I have seen the affliction of my people. I know their sorrows. I know their sorrows. And I have held their cry." And he speaks in verse number 8. He says to Moses, he says, "Now I am come down to deliver my people out of the hand of Pharaoh and to give them their precious land, a land flowing with milk and honey." And so God visited his people by Moses, and the people came out of Egypt. And Hosea chapter 12 and verse 13, the Bible says, by a prophet Israel was delivered out of Egypt, and by a prophet was he preserved. And this prophet was the man Moses. So what am I saying here? God can visit a nation
And
it is his will to visit this country. It is his will to visit this country. He wants to visit us economically. He wants to visit us financially, in agriculture. He wants to visit us in every facet of our nation. But I want us also to know that God can also visit individuals. He wants to visit you individually. Yes, he can visit a nation. He can visit a community of people. He can visit a society of people. He can visit a whole family. But he can also visit individuals. And I know he's visiting you this hour. In the mighty name of Jesus, I want to draw your attention to the book of Genesis chapter
18.
When you read verse number 10, God visited Abraham.
He
saw three men coming to him, and he compelled them to sit down and wait for a meal. He didn't know that he was entertaining angels. And after the men ate, one of them said to Abraham, "Where is your wife Sarah?" And then he said, "He's there in the tent." And then the angel of the Lord spoke to Abraham. He said, "But this time next year, I'm going to visit you. And your wife Sarah is going to have a son. And you shall call his name Isaac." And then verse number 10. The Bible says, "Then the Lord said, I will surely return to you by this time next year. Sarah, your wife will have a son." Sarah, your wife will have a son. That is what I call a personal divine visitation. And I read in Genesis chapter 21, verses 1 to 2. The Bible says, "Now the Lord was gracious to Sarah, as he had promised. And the Lord did for Sarah what he had promised. Sarah became pregnant and bore a son to Abraham in his old age, at the very time that God promised. At the very time that God promised." Listen to me. This is the time. I said, this is that time that God has promised to visit. I want you to get set for his visitation. The same God who visited the Jews in Egypt is visiting you in your own
Egypt.
In the mighty name of Jesus. The same God who visited Sarah in her barrenness is visiting you in your own predicament. In the mighty name of Jesus. We also read in 1 Samuel chapter
1
that God visited a woman by the name Hannah. She was a barren woman. Barrenness simply means fruitless labor. I know some of you have experienced fruitless efforts. You try hard, but you also fail hard. You don't really know what is happening to you. I have a good news for you. There is a visitation. I said there is a visitation. In the mighty name of Jesus, you are being visited in your barrenness. You are being visited in your prison houses. You are being visited in your sicknesses. And there's going to be change by this visitation. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, shout
hallelujah.
And I read in 1 Samuel chapter 2. And verse number
21.
The Bible says, "And the Lord was gracious to Hannah. She conceived and gave birth to three sons and two daughters. Meanwhile, the boy Samuel grew up in the presence of the Lord."
Nyamata Samuel adakula pamaso pamulungu.
We are looking here at a woman.
Tikuona apa msimai.
Who was barren?
Amina
nalocha ereka. And God visited her in 1 Samuel chapter 1.
Ndipo ambuya adamuyendera mu 1 Samuel chapter 1.
And through the power of prayer.
Ndiye kutera mphamvu ya pemphero.
She experienced a breakthrough in her life.
Anapeza kubolesa moyo wake.
And she gave birth to a bouncing baby boy.
Nabereka mwana mphamvu wa
Mungu. By the name Samuel.
Zina lake Samuel.
And she surrendered him to the Lord.
Nampereka kwa mbuye.
And we read in this verse of scripture.
Ndiye tuwerenga palemba hili.
1 Samuel 2:21. That God visited Hannah again and again.
Adamu endelanso Hannah mobweleza bweleza.
There is somebody listening to me right now.
Bali wina wake amina kunivela tobani.
Who is going to experience an avalanche of visitations?
Amen. Akalandile kuendeleza mobweleza bweleza.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Hannah was visited 6 times. You are going to be visited more than 6 times. In the mighty name of Jesus. Because some of you need a visitation in your marriage. And then you also need a visitation in your finances. You also need a visitation concerning your unruly, troublesome children. You also need a visitation concerning your business. At the office, you also have trouble. You need another visitation there. That is how I know you are experiencing multiple visitations. You are experiencing multiple visitations in the mighty name of Jesus. Better believe this word of prophecy, my friend, because the Bible says, believe the Lord your God and you shall be established. Believe also his prophets and you shall prosper. And I stand here as a prophet of God, declaring unto you that you are going to experience multiple visitations in the mighty name of Jesus. God wants to visit you personally, and all the people around you are going to know that you have surely been visited in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody shout, I need a visitation. Say it again, I need a visitation. And I want you to shout out loud, I am ready for a visitation. I need multiple visitations in my life in the precious name of Jesus. The visitations are on your way. Accept the visitations are on your way in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, what happens when the Lord visits somebody? What happens when the Lord visits somebody's life? There are several things that I want to talk to you about, but I think for this week I'll give you 3. What happens when the Lord visits you? Number 1. There is fruitfulness. There is fruitfulness. When God visited Abraham and Sarah, their barrenness was averted. I said their barrenness was averted, and fruitfulness came to be. We read in 1 Samuel 2:21 that God was gracious unto Hannah, and God gave her children 3 sons and 2 daughters besides Samuel. That is how I know multiplication is taking place in your life. So when God visits you, you should expect multiplication. You should expect fruitfulness in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Every form of fruitless labor is coming. It is coming to an end in the name of Jesus. When God visited Hannah, there was fruitfulness. When God visited Sarah, there was fruitfulness. So wherever God visits, fruitfulness is a must in the mighty name of Jesus. And so I want you to expect great and mighty things in your businesses, in your marriages, in the works of your hands, because there is a mighty visitation. Now, number 2. What else happens when the Lord visits? There is worth or abundance. There is worth and abundance. You remember we read from Genesis chapter 15, verses 13 to 16, where God spoke to Abraham, told him, your people are going to be slaves in a strange country, but I will visit them and deliver them out of that nation. And then God spoke in verse number 14, in Genesis 15 and verse number 14, he said, when the people shall get out of the land, they shall get out with great substance. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is how I know, my friend, you are in for great substance. You are in for worth. There is going to be an envy provoking financial breakthrough for you in the mighty name of Jesus. So when Joseph's prophecy came to pass, that God visited the people of God, we read in Exodus chapter number 12, verses 33 to 36. Exodus chapter 12, verses 33 to 36. That when the people were getting out, they left with great substance. They plundered the Egyptians. I don't know what Egyptian has been tormenting your life, but I want you to know that Egypt is being plundered in the mighty name of Jesus. You are getting out of that situation with a great substance. I said you are leaving that situation with great substance in the mighty name of Jesus. So when God visits, there is fruitfulness. Number two, there is substance. There is wealth that comes to you. Number three, when God visits the people, he brings promotion. He brings promotion. I said he brings promotion. Listen to the testimony of Hannah. After God had given her a son in Samuel, the Bible says she composed a song and she began to sing, and she said, the Lord raises the poor from the dust and he lifts the needy from the ashes and he sees them among the princes. Listen to me, my friend, your own lifting has arrived in the mighty name of Jesus. I said your own lifting has arrived in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord is picking you out of the dust. He's raising you out of the ashes. And he's sitting you in your rightful place in the mighty name of Jesus. Habakkuk chapter 3, verses 18 to 19. He says, God has prepared a place for me.
He
says, there is a high place that God has prepared for me.
And
I want to announce as a prophet of God that the hour has come for you to occupy your high place, and it shall happen by divine visitation. You believe it, shout
hallelujah.
There is promotion for you. I said there is promotion for you. I said there is promotion for you. You remember in Genesis 41, verses 37 to 46, God visited Joseph in the prison house. He caused Pharaoh to have a dream for which he needed interpretation. And God strategically positioned Joseph to interpret the dream. And it was by the interpretation of this dream that he was catapulted to the position of prime minister. So a prisoner became a captain. Hallelujah. And it was by divine visitation. I said it was by divine visitation. It was by divine visitation. So it doesn't matter what prison you are in. It could be a financial prison, a marital prison, a career prison, a ministry prison. Whatever dimension of prison you are dealing with right now, listen to me, child of God. Listen to me, people of God. There is a visitation for you. I said there is a visitation for you. I said there is a visitation for you. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. So when God visits, promotion is inevitable. I want to pray with those that are saying, Pastor, I want a divine visitation in my life. I want a divine visitation. Please stand with me in prayer for a divine visitation. It doesn't matter what area of need you're dealing with. I want you to know that God is visiting you. I want you to put your right hand on your chest in the mighty name of Jesus, because I'm about to pray right now. There's going to be change by divine visitation. There's going to be a release of God's power that is going to destroy the opposition and set you free. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I decree a release of your power upon the lives and situations of your people. Let there be restoration. Let there be freedom. In the mighty name of Jesus, let every barrenness be affected. In the name of Jesus, let fruitfulness spring forth. Let wealth and abundance come out. In the mighty name of Jesus, let there be promotion on every side for your people. In the mighty name of Jesus, I thank God and bless you, Father, because of such a great miracle that is already taking place in the lives of your people. In Jesus' mighty name, God bless you. I want you to believe that it has happened for you. Please send in your testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to pray with you, those that have not yet received Jesus. If you have not yet accepted Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, your life is in danger. Why don't you accept him today for your salvation? Pray this prayer after me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I confess my sin. I confess that I am a sinner. I ask you to have mercy upon me. And I invite you, Jesus, to enter into my life. You be Lord and Savior of my life, even from this day. In Jesus' name. God bless you. See you again next time.
Pastor Esau Banda has just placed in your hands the key to abundant life, hope, and all-round enlargement. All your hopelessness and struggles are over in Jesus' mighty name. Please share your testimony with us by writing an email to pastoresaubanda@gmail.com, or you can call us on 0995-297-565. 0-888-648-398. 0-999-118-685. 0-999-387-753. Or 0-999-581-503. And best of all, come hear the man of God live as you worship with us at Hayat Complex, opposite Maola Parish, Chirambura Road, Lilongwe. On Thursdays, Word Encounter service from 5:30 p.m. to 7 o'clock p.m. On Saturdays, Breakthrough service from 5 o'clock a.m. to 7 o'clock a.m. And on Sundays, First service from 7 o'clock a.m. to 9:30 a.m. Second service from 10 o'clock a.m. to 12:30 p.m. Healing and Deliverance service from 3 o'clock p.m. to to 5 o'clock p.m.